Well, how's it going, buddy? I'm Burhead 2. Welcome back to more peak Pikmin 4 gameplay. Fair talk to Colin.
Pinuko!
Let's go explore.
Onyanong.
Which area would you like to explore? All of them. Ah, the Sunspickle Terrace. I know that name because I've heard it before. Yeah, okay. Whatever. Oh, the onion's going too? Now, there's a big... Sorry. There's a big question, of course, in the Pikmin fan base. What's the best design onion? Is it the first two games, or Pikmin 3, Pikmin 4? I gotta say right now, my money's on Pikmin 3's onion. I like that one the most. It's just, this one doesn't sit the well, doesn't sit quite as, just, I don't like it that much. It's just strange looking. I kinda like the mechanicalness of the onion in Pikmin 3. Alright then. Okay, here we go.
Hello?
Come in, come in. This is Colin. Looks like you made it to there in one piece. Hang on, I'll have the captain explain how today's rescue operation will work. See that clock at the top left corner of your screen? It says that the hand will reach the rightmost edge of the area's local sunset sign. Search for our missing rescue officers during the day, but hustle back to the rescue command post before dark. Hey, let's copy that. We're counting on you. Oh, you probably noticed the onion accompanied the SS Beagle. According to the voyage log, the onions also serves as a form of transportation for the Pikmin. We've got a lot to do, and it can take care of all the help we can, get. I think you could put those Pikmin to good use. So, yeah, I'm just gonna do all this. All of them. No cutscene for that this time? That's strange. Alright, so. So I'm gonna put two on that. That's a pretty rock, isn't it? Yes, Colin, it's a very nice rock. It doesn't seem like the treasure, like treasure, but it might be useful. I'll check Captain Olimar's voyage log. Could one mistake this raw material for a simple stone? One could, but it is more in common with amber and other fossilized biological matter. When heated, it melts down into clay and becomes malleable. I should be able to find many applications for it. It melts into clay? It melts into clay. I'm a fair hand with machines, but I don't know much about material science. If we hand our scientist back, I bet he'd be able to make good use of this. Collect it for now. I'll be excited to have something to work on with after we find him. I was gonna steal that one, but okay. Now we have just enough paper for this. Wonderful. I am admittedly not the biggest fan of this new day meter. I like the old one. Oh, the Pikmin automatically. Okay. More. Huh? The onion stops spreading out seeds. Based on life signals from inside the onion, there are more equivalent Pikmin in there. This is the Pikmin cap tutorial? Maybe Pikmin have evolved to self-limit how many can be out on the surface at a time to prevent unnecessary loss. That's 20 Pikmin. Oh, I heard you can upgrade the Pikmin limit in this game. We're going to... Let's read the voyage logs here. As evening fell, Pikmin climbed back. The onion took off the skies along to the SS Dolphin. Astonishing, the onion must be a nest and form of transportation. The onion stopped releasing seeds. I went check on it and saw that Pikmin only, put, only propagate inside the onion once a certain number are out on the surface. Eliminating the number of active Pikmin may be a strategy to avoid extinction. The fire is the natural enemy of the Pikmin, but red Pikmin continue through the flames where other Pikmin would burn. Their attacks are also a bit, little bit stronger than those of other Pikmin. Could these qualities be related somehow? I read that one already. So there's 80 all in all voyage logs, apparently. Good to know, I suppose. Now, I just have something I wanted to mention, but I, of course, forgot what it was already. So, we're just gonna play some Pikmin. Can't go up there. Doesn't seem to be a ramp in the immediate area. Oh my gosh. And more. Come in Burrhead 2. I forgot an important detail, that is, you're going to need Ochi's help when it comes to searching for the rescue officers. He has a sharp sense of smell, so he'll be able to locate the rescue officers by tracking their scents. Use that to open actions, and use that to select search command.
Right.
Begin with the command Ochi to pick up a scent. You never know where his nose may lead you. Rescue operations are a race against time, so put your Dandori skill, Dandori skills, to work and find your rescue officers quickly. I am the Dandori master over here. Look a little confused. Have you never heard the term Dandori before, Burrhead 2? How to explain? I know what it is. You'd be good at the video game. Dandori is the art of organizing your tasks strategically and working with maximum efficiency to rescue, execute your plans quickly. His practice has fallen by the wayside in recent years, but it's still a core tenant of the rescue corps, so take it apart. Take it too hard. Take it apart. Embracing the art of Dandori is essential to our work. We need your lot. Searching rescue options, blah blah blah, to get things started. Whatever. Command. Oh, I have to confirm. Okay, so these guys are a little far behind. Let's see if we can fix that. There we go. Ochi, where are you going? In a minute, Ochi. Oh, so don't go back to where you started. They stay here, like in Pikmin 3. Okay. There's more stuff on my tablet. Ochi, where are you going? Wait for me!
Ochi!
Something about this wall. Hello there. Fire through three, but apparently. Almost broke. Ochi can track you. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. I'm working on it, man. Melting into clay. That's just ridiculous. How do you melt into clay? Clay's supposed to be wet. I picked it up. Cool. Okay, so Ochi goes over there. We'll be back in a second, Ochi. I'm kind of busy. It's the like first quarter of the day. Or first of, like, what is that? Seven dots. I guess it's the first quarter of the quarter of the day, because the last one really wouldn't count, would it? Oh yeah, that would still need to be four for it to be a quarter. You know what I mean. It's like the first third or something. Alright, so let's go over here and find ourselves what I'm assuming is going to be Ice Pikmin. Also, how's my, audio quality? I've been trying to... I did some test recordings yesterday to try and iron out some of the details. Ooh, nectar eggs. It looks like a yolk. Did you see that? It bloomed a flower. What's going on here? That substance is called nectar. When people consume it, it simulates their growth, apparently. The voyage log says that the more they grow, the faster they move. They really are mysterious creatures. Drink all of it.
Oh,
look, there's a cave here too. This area is crawling with creatures. Our rescue officers should have retreated into the cave to get away from them. Well, we should probably take a look inside. But what's around this area? I thought it might tell me the name of the cave. Let's see, I can't really seem to do much here. Ah, there's more stuff. We'll do that in a second. First, the cave, of course. There's more stuff back there. Now let's just do what the game wants me to do. I wonder if there might be a voyage log entry related to these coordinates. Yep, here it is. Last Frost Cavern. I entered a cave to look for the SS Dolphin parts, and I found a creature that defies the logic of space. It further surprised me by expelling a frigid cold air. Imagine if there were Pikmin that had been climbed that cold air. This planet's ecosystem is full of mysteries. Take a look at this. That Captain Olimar certainly is thorough, isn't he? According to the log, anytime you enter a cave, you should take a Pikmin with you. Or Pikmin, plural. The SS Beagle can bring the Pikmin, so you might enter the cave without stopping. So you can enter the cave without stopping by the base first. Oh, interesting. The Pikmin that remain on the surface can't be left out there, so return to the onion for the time being. I can go down, like, different sub-levels just to start with? Alright, well. Yeah, let's do it. Oh, nice. It's the Pikmin 2-1. Cool. I like that. Yeah. Now, I've heard there's, like, pale onions or something. Like, you can upgrade the onion with it. I don't know what that is.
Pardon?
Good boy, Ochi. He's picked up a castaway scent. How do you know that? It has to be one of our missing Rescue Corps officers. Time to get them back to safety. Alright, let's do this thing. Some female shoe grubs. I like that. Well, it's fine, I guess. Always good, I guess. Oops. Oh, what's going on over there? Ice Pikmin! What's this? That's not treasure.
But,
treasure or not, it does appear to contain some sparklium. You might as well keep collecting these tree-feeding creatures. They might be enough to help, even if only a little. So, go ahead and bring that. More nectar. Alright. Treasure, it's another compass. Okay, let's look at this. It's stuff to read over here. Okay, that's just that. Dave Shepherd. Onions. Anything over here? The red Pikmin? Pikmin maturation. I've noticed that when they consume nectar, a flower immediately blooms on the Pikmin's head. Yet, when they mature in the ground from a sprout, the leaf becomes a bud before a flower. Either way, the more they go, the faster the Pikmin become. That could be useful. There's four treasures in
here.
Good, no energy can get. Shut up, Colin. I'm tired of seeing your face. Are those wild Pikmin? Hell no. They could be dangerous. No. Why would I need to do that? No. Okay. That'll be fine, right? Yeah, they're fine. No cutscene for that? Unlike in Pikmin 3, yes, I'll take that to be honest. What that is. Oh, is that Mario Paint brand? It better be. Doesn't look like it. That is. Speaking of pale onions, there's one right now. Oh, what? There's ice Pikmin just sitting there? Are these Pikmin 2? No, it's Pikmin 4. Let's see. The voyage log says, I always thought as Pikmin as plant-like creatures, so I never dreamed I'd come across an ice variant. Ice Pikmin can use the icy bodies to freeze water and creatures, but they also float like ice in the water. Don't spray them with water, though. They really don't like it.
Aww.
Their bodies are made of ice? Who knew that something frozen could move around like that? It's incredible. And have, like, traction. So those Pikmin don't blow idle, apparently.
No.
Does it look like it's sputtering? It looks pretty pale for an onion. What do you think? Should we take it with us? Oh, gee, that's a good job for you. And two extra Pikmin because it takes five. I am Dandorying extremely hard right now. Also take that. Five on that. Like that is. It's shivering and I don't like that. That's kind of gross. See, I was doing some test recordings the other day. Just really try and dial it in. The audio and stuff. Whenever I do a Let's Play, it's like the first 15 episodes of just me trying to figure out how the audio works and trying to make it sound good. So, I just tuned it to the earbuds I'm using right now. I don't know if it's going to sound good on speakers or not. I'll figure that out later, I guess. Huh? The onion is different somehow? Well, this onion is different. Let's take it back to the surface so we can compare it with the other onion. Hello, Ochi.
Blue.
Huh? That seems like a lot of Pikmin. It's just quite bigger than normal. Why? Shut up! Oh, I see. When you're underground, you can have a larger squad because of the wild Pikmin you found will join you. Or find will join you. Okay, yeah. But that was extremely important. Next tutorial is going to be about how these ice Pikmin have a different color flower than the other ones. Ochi. That's taking too long. What? He's frozen. Quick, call him with the whistle. Make sure he's alright. I don't care. So I guess Ice Pikmin do less damage than the other Pikmin types, apparently. That took forever. Ochi, you're taking that. Bro, he ate it. Bro, what? Actually, I want to make these flowers. No different color flower tutorial? That's true. Oh, she has arrived. Yeah, cool. A little late for that information there, Colin. Okay, let's do on the tablet. New voyage log. Whenever the underlings are in a bad spot, it's the leader's duty to remain calm, quickly assess the situation, and form a plan of action. For example, when the Pikmin are in trouble and start to panic, I can calm them and re-engage their focus using my whistle. And that's... There's... more voyage log. Where? Okay, so that's just that. So, this is going to work on Ochi. Worked for him. Even Ochi can't chew his way through this one. It had to be Ice Pikmin next.
Watch out!
Just like that, frozen solid. I bet you can break it if you hit it now. Give the order to the Pikmin or Ochi. Hydro Jelly. Oh, now they glow. I bet because they were glowing, it was just a special condition because they're wild Pikmin or something. It's not that amazing. That's another cutscene over there, that's for sure. And they're fast. Okay, that's everybody. This is a one sublevel cave. Lame. We found a castaway! Hurry and check their vitals. Pulse, blood pressure, temperature, all within normal parameters. Looks like their life support system did its job.
Come on.
We should transport them back to the SS Beagle and verify their ID badge. What if it's like... somebody different, though. What of that? They want to get this done with faster, I guess. I don't know. I'm too uppity. I'm too uptight with this. I just need to relax.
Honey.
Play the game I want to play. And play it the way I want to play. You did it. Let's take a look and see what the ID badge tells us.
Oh.
Hey, this is, like, hey, Pikmin. An inventor, material engineer, and lover of all things science. He's also kind of creepy looking. He can develop all kinds of useful gadgets with the right raw materials. Oh, thanks the stars, he's all right. This is Russ, the scientist in charge of repairs and upgrades for our spacesuits in the SS Shepherd. His technical knowledge will be beyond helpful during this rescue mission. It's the first three. You found Russ, the rescue corps' talented as scientist. Keep searching for the rest of the rescue officers. Yep. Okay, I've been having some fun so far. Oh, she is very slow. Okay, we gotta read the ID badges. Hello, Russ. I can't A on it, doesn't do anything. Oh, voyage log, what's going on over here? I missed it. Which one was it? While Pikmin found underground could be brought to the surface and added to the onion, however, when tasked with transporting a pellet, the resulting seeds end up the same color as the onion. Must be careful, as these Pikmin cannot be propagated right now. Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. So let's go ahead and return to the surface then. It's also the Pikmin 2 theme. That's just great. This is 2. It's just great. I like that. Director of Destiny. That's the Pikmin 2 name. Refreshing Goo. That's interesting. And 7 creatures. Hooray. I guess. Yeah. Some little details. Alright then. That's taking a long time to load. Can you hurry up, please? I don't have all day. That music felt cut short.
Thomas.
I'm sure I synchronized your clock, Burrhead. 2 for something's off. I calculated the difference. It looks as if about 1/6 as much time has passed on the surface as you spent underground. Time seems to move differently in the underground spaces on this planet.
Oh.
I'm not sure how it works, but I suppose that means it can take as much time as you'll need to explore caves. Interesting. Another voyage log.
What?
Hey, the alien sucked it up. The voyage log says that the white bulb is called Farlick. Oh, okay.
Boy.
If we bring Farlick to the onion, it will increase the number of Pikmin it releases on the surface at any time, at one time, by 10. Whoa, that'd be a big help when you're exploring. Try taking out more Pikmin. We'll just... Yeah, nothing. Alright then. Well, better end this off right now. We're getting a decently long episode here. Well, anyway, thanks for watching. See you guys in the next one then. Bye.